Very nice people. You have very good, decent moral behaviors. So we welcome you. Is that what they told them? You are liars. You are here to do fitna. This is what you're here for. What are you here for? You are cheaters. You are this. They, every single name in the book that they had back then, they called them. Huh? Didn't they call them like that? Didn't the munafiqeen went as far as accusing Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sayyidah Aisha radhiyallahu anha? They would go like that. They would go that far. There's many people that would go that far. Available every time. Huh? At your disposal. How was the reaction of the people? Did they say that? Was it welcoming? Or was it accusing? Or was it always degrading? Or was it always belittling? Or was it always cursing? Was it always cussing? Suspecting? What was, which one was it? Was it comfortable? They welcomed them? Here's some food, why don't you? Since you're only asking us to be good, you're asking us to not to lie, not to cheat, not to steal, not to this, why don't you become... What are you talking about? Two, you're saying you're messengers and you actually have... You're holding the moral standard here, that what is that going to do to my jobs? What is it going to do to our clubs? What is it going to do to these things? Things are going to change. There's going to be shuffling of some cards. Huh? فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا. Therefore they had to say, you are liars. What do you mean messengers? Huh? Allah says, فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا. Two, فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِفِ. Allah sent another one. One village, three. Not one messenger. Three. فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِفِ. What did they say? قَالُوا إِنَّا لَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ. We were sent to you. Huh? Do we ask, are we asking you for anything? No. Are we asking you for position? No. Are we asking you for money? No. إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ. They looked at them, they said, well, what do we do with these people? We called them every name in the book. We didn't succeed. We followed them to make, to see how many mistakes we can write on them. It didn't work out. Huh? We have these people with red pens always. What happened then? قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا. You are people like us. What are you talking about? You say, yeah, you are messengers. You are just people, human beings like us. ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء. Allah did not, الرحمن, if there is a Rahman, He did not send anything. إن أنتم لا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إن عليكم مرسل. Allah, our Lord who sent us, if you don't believe in us, fine. What is this here? If you don't believe in us, Allah, our Lord, who sent us to you, knows that we are His messengers. Look at the stand right here. Focus on it a little bit. Are they waiting for the appreciation and the recognition of people? Are they waiting for the people to acknowledge them as prophets and glorious people and great people? What is then, what are they relying on? رَبُّنَا يَعْلَمْ. Allah, our Lord knows. They didn't say Allah. رَبُّنَا. This is even closer. Our Lord knows that we are messengers to you. In other words, our standards with, of dealing with you does not depend on your action towards us. It depends on us being the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Notice? It's not what you do to me, that's how I deal with you. That's not how it is in Islam. In Islam, you have, there's a standard. Two wrongs do not make it right. And therefore, if someone curses you, would you curse him again? No. A matter of fact, the Quran al-Kareem goes further than that. لَا تَشُبُّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the Quran, لَا تَشُبُّ. Do not cuss. Do not belittle. Notice. The gods of other people. There is no god but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But people who make things God, do not belittle their gods so they don't belittle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this. Even if they worship something else, when someone is worshiping a monkey or a donkey, whatever it is that they're worshiping, don't belittle that. Why? They don't talk about you. Yeah. Al-Quran goes further, and you see in Al-Quran this dialogue. Right. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء. قالوا ربنا يعلم إن إلىكم وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. Our job is just to let you know, just to tell you, we are not asking you of anything. They gathered together, the people of the village, they got together, the council, the chiefs, the delegates, whoever you want. There are always chiefs every time. Problem is, there are too many chiefs and not enough Indians. We need some Indians so you can have enough chiefs. over them, but there's not. Five. So all the chiefs got together in that village and they made a decision. What do we do with these people? We called them every name, it didn't stick. We tried to stop them, it didn't work. So what do we do to them? قَالُوا إِنَّا تَطَيَّرْنَا بِكُمْ They even went to these their fortune tellers and all these people, whatever it is that they have done, all their magic, all their things. And then they came to them and they said, look, we're going to be nice to you out of civility because we're civilized. We have even went further out to even ask the fortune tellers and the fortune things and all these things. We are going to give you one last chance. لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهُوا Now one last chance, so out of the generosity and the kindness of us, if you don't stop you calling for these morals and ethics, لَنَرْجُمَنَّكُمْ We will stone you. وَلَيَمَسَّنَّكُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابٌ Look at this. If you don't stop, what are they doing? Are they taking money from them? No, are they taking from them? No, all they're saying is, you know, don't lie, don't steal, don't cheat, believe in the Creator, don't believe in the creation. That's not good enough. لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَوْ لَنَرْجُمَنَّكُمْ وَلَيَمَسَّنَّكُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ What was again the reply of the messengers in that point in time? Again, another stand. قَالُوا طَائِرُكُمْ مَعَكُمْ أَنْ ذُكِّرْتُمْ بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ مُسْرِفُونَ If that's what you want to do, that's what you do. You have to do what you have to do. We do what we do. Because haqq does not have different colors and different facades, and haqq here is different than haqq there, and haqq is always haqq. So they said, this is, we are accounted with a message, you do what you do, and we will continue doing what we continue. وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ يَسْعَى Now a man comes from the end of the village, he hears people are gathering, all the village gathering around these messengers, one wants to kill them, the other wants to stone them, the one calls them names, one belittles them, and they are the messengers of Allah Jalla Jalaluh. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ He listened to them, this man with intellect. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we worship Allah because Allah gave us the mind. Yani the brain that we have is an endowment, a ni'mah, and without the brain we couldn't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, the mu'min is the one who uses his mind all the time, thinks about things, is not irrational, is always rational. Things about it. This is what it is. You're thinking so you can make, you come to the best decision. This man was thinking, Habibul Najjar, his name, among the narrators they say his name is Habibul Najjar. Habibul Najjar comes, he's listening to what the messengers are saying on one hand, and what the people are saying on the other hand. And then he came to truth. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ Oh my people, why don't you follow what they're saying? اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ اتَّبِعُوا مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ Follow them, they're not asking. Are they asking you any money? Follow those who don't ask you any money. And they are rightly guided. And they looked at him and said, now, you are with them? It was contagious. It also became one of them. قَالَ وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي Why shouldn't I worship the one who created me? Why should I worship the creation versus the creator? No, the creator, not the creation. وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي وَلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ They said, we give you also, you also one of them, now, you also, you're our own, but now you belong to them, since you believe like them. So we'll give you one last chance to believe in our gods and abandon the god of these people. قَالَ Then what he said? وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ أَتَّخِذُ مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً إِن يُرِدْنِ الرَّحْمَنُ بِضُرٍّ لَا تُغْنِي عَنِّي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْئًا وَلَا يُنْقِذُونَ Should I take? Would I replace worshipping the Creator by worshipping the creation that cannot help itself? They came, of course, they put the knife on him, on his neck, and they said, now you deserve to die. And they let the knife go, little by little, until his soul started leaving his body, his honorable soul left his body. And then, as you all know, when one dies, he sees his sight either in Jannah or Jahannam, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى Where he's going to end up. May Allah make us all among the people of Jannah. He saw the Malaika came and showed him his place in paradise. They killed him, huh? And then the Quran mentions, قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ I wish my people would know. Look at his mercy, look at this. Sifat al-Mu'min, this is the characteristic of a Mu'min. They're killing him, but he wants to go back to them to say, I wish. The Quran is talking on his behalf still, after his death. قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ I wish that my people are seeing what I am seeing with my own eyes, then they would understand what I'm talking about. وَمَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَى قَوْمِهِ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ مِنْ جُنْدٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا